Thank you. talk to Monster. But she doesn't want to sit by herself. Yeah. Yeah. You're going to create that. Yeah, education.
Welcome to the 66th commencement exercises for RHAM High School. We are thrilled to be in person with all of you on this beautiful evening to celebrate the exceptional RHAM class of 2023. Please join us in standing for the national anthem being performed by our senior vocal quartet.
Say, can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight, o'er the ramparts we watched were so gallantly streaming, and the rockets the bombs for the land of the
seniors, you may now have a seat. Eyes on page. All right. Good job.
Oh, yes, you can sit.
If you're wondering why we have a dog in our ceremony this year, we have Barnabas, who is our guest graduate. He has been a steady therapy dog for us all year long. And so I'd like to give a nice round of applause to Barnabas. To officially welcome all of you, I would like to call Dan Tamburo, our senior class president, to the podium.
I think they would have given me a teleprompter or something. All right. Before I get too philosophical here, I owe a few thank yous. None of us got this far alone, of course. Mr. Kokas, I'm not sure how carefully you read my band reflection, but simply put, I and many other grads would be much worse people if it weren't for you. I don't know what else to say besides thank you. Sorry for making you eat that vomit-flavored jelly bean in Disney. Life is only as fun as you make it. Magistra Banks, she's back here somewhere. You run an exceptional Latin program all on your own. Logan and I have been lucky beyond belief to study with you for 6 years. Caecilius est vivus. To the administrators, I think I speak for the whole class when I say, we're sorry for making a mess all over the school. Mom and Dad, you've been with me through it all. No one on earth could ask for better parents. And I don't tell you that enough. Julius Caesar once said, Ut est rerum omnium magister usus. Or roughly translated, experience is the teacher of all things. I apologize to everybody who still thinks Latin is a dead language. Besides teaching us the complexities of physics, Shakespeare, or even how to get to class 2 seconds before the bell, RHAM has filled us with the memories and experiences of a lifetime. In our freshman year, it felt like we were robbed of a normal high school experience by COVID. I still don't know if we all recognize how formative that was. The last major pandemic happened over 100 years ago. Hopefully there won't be a next one. Regardless, this will be something that we can tell stories about to our children and our grandchildren. After sticking it out, we finally made it back for what most would consider a normal senior year. I know I say this often, but the music department has been there for a lot of us through it all. I think Laura Filosa put it best when she said something along the lines of it was the best time many of us had spent in high school. Personally, I can't truly decide what I'll miss most from my normal senior year, whether it be dancing at prom, where Miss Mead stole the show, by the way, using flash passes at Six Flags after being delayed, albeit, watching the sunrise as a class, staging a wedding as a prank in the atrium, helioing around school, or simply eating lunch with my friends during a busy day. I wouldn't trade any of it for the world. Honorable mention to watching Conrad smash raw eggs against his head for stats class. Perhaps more important, however, is taking a closer look at just exactly what the word normal means. Although many of us have formed bonds in class, on the stage, or on the field, I guarantee that no two of us have had anything close to a similar or identical high school experience. There are no guidelines, instructions, or set of rules that dictate how best to normally lead your high school experience or how best to normally lead your life. Let's be honest, who wants to be normal and conform anyways? Didn't that great comedian Mel Brooks say that to live is to be noisy and colorful and lively? So looking back, class of 2023, we certainly had anything but a normal experience. That fact alone is enough to guarantee we're the best class to ever walk across this stage. As we all embark on the next chapter in our lives, for our own sakes, for the sake of Mel Brooks, and for the sake of the world, let's be anything but normal. It is now my distinct pleasure to introduce the guest speaker for the class of 2023's commencement. During the difficulties of the COVID-19 pandemic, Michelle Nicholson used her passion for baking to support her neighbors and the community as a whole. Today, having been recognized on both the state and national level, she owns and operates Hebron's famous Flower Girl Bakery and Flower Girl Cafe. She and her talented team continue to use their skills to support a culture of innovation, excellence, and positivity in the surrounding area. In her own words, she strives to bake the world a better place. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Dan, and everyone, for having me here today. It is such an honor to have been asked to be here not only as a speaker at graduation, but at this graduation specifically. I have been so blessed to have so many of you in the audience today be by my side over the past few years. You have supported my business, and a few of you being honored here today have had a hand in building my dream. My name is Michelle Nicholson. I'm a Hebron resident of 9 years and a mother of three. I grew up in a small town in New Hampshire, and I hold a master's degree in business and marketing from Salve Regina University. I am also known as the Flower Girl. My role as a small business owner is, I assume, what has placed me on this stage today. I would like to talk to you a little bit about the communities that I have been a part of over the years and the impact that they've had on me. Mark Anthony said that when you do what you love, you never work a day in your life. The journey for me to find what I love started in high school. As I look at this crowd today, I am reminded of my own high school graduation. I graduated from a regional public high school in New Hampshire with about 60 classmates. My class sizes were small, my class options were limited, but my school taught me about what it means to be in a community in a small town. Growing up in that environment showed me how to give the community you are a part of and what you will give back from that investment of time and energy. When I graduated from that small school, I went to another small school. Though Salve Regina was much larger than the high school friends that they chose in comparison, you know, they were picking major universities, the community that I found at college was different. I got a job in the business studies department and began working for the department chair. By the time I gave my time and attention to those around me, but this time in return, I gained knowledge, respect, and connections. Connections that I then used as a graduating senior to get my first real job. Already aware that charity was so important to me, I applied for a position at a national nonprofit in healthcare. Even though I had no experience and was far too young for the job, one of my connections from my undergraduate days gave me an opportunity to prove myself. Working for a national charity was both rewarding and eye-opening. It taught me many things, but I yearned for the small town that I came from. When we moved to Hebron after my son was born, I was finally in a spot, again, where I could set down roots. I immediately threw myself into every organization I could. I joined the Moms Club, the Education Foundation, and any other opportunity I could find. With the help of friends and volunteers, I ran candy cane hunts, Polar Express pajama parties, designer bag bingo, and mud runs. I was so sure that I wanted to do something that allowed me a vehicle and a platform to belong to the community. But I hadn't found that thing yet, the job, the one where it doesn't feel like you're working. It was 4 years ago when I began the process of learning to make sourdough bread, the first step in a journey that spiraled to where I am today. Bread was definitely my thing, but also it was much more. I settled into this town and I dug deep. People shared posts and talked about my little business and helped me grow. They shouted out my success and quietly consoled my failures. My community was there for it, so I was there for them. I donated muffins and sweet rolls and hot cross buns, raised money for charities and sponsored t-ball teams. As the flower girl grew rapidly, I hit a lot of bumps in the road. But again, they were there. You were there. When I was selling bread out of my porch and selling out every week, they set alarms to order on Sunday at 4 p.m. When we started crashing websites, they placed their names into the weekly bread lottery. When I suddenly couldn't sell from my porch anymore, they offered me their homes, their kitchens, and eventually their church. When I was outgrowing that space, my community connected me with a couple who literally built me a bakery. And when I couldn't afford the cost of the equipment to go into it, this same community bought sourdough classes, mugs, and magnets to help me raise over $15,000 in 48 hours. My community invested in me as I had invested in it. This business, this bakery and cafe, it is my dream, but my community built it for me, and I'm grateful for that every single day. I'm often too busy now to appreciate the magnitude of where this business is in comparison to where it was only 2 years ago. But sometimes when I'm walking between the buildings at 4 a.m. or dropping back to ensure that I turned off an oven at midnight, I find myself caught off guard by what we did together. I'm so blessed to have found something that I enjoy doing so much, and I truly believe that I have found my thing that I love the most. And when you do what you love, you will never work a day in your life, right? Well, no offense to Mark Anthony, but I completely disagree. When you do what you love, when you find that goal, that dream, you will work harder than you have ever worked on anything in your life. You'll work faster and longer and more passionately. You will care more, be more stressed, more nervous, and more uncertain than you have ever been. But that's how you will know that you have found what you love. At the end of the day, when you go home exhausted, or maybe you don't even go home, maybe you're thinking that the stress mat covered in flour looks like a great place to sleep for the night. But when you have a minute to sit back and see what you've done, I promise you will see your community. The community that you built and that built you, that supported you, is going to be there to say that it was worth it. And when your community tells you how much your work means to them, today, when your family tells you how much this day means to them, I believe that you will also understand, just as I have, that it wasn't really work at all. Graduates of 2023 and the community that got you here, congratulations to all of you. I hope you go on to find your thing and to bring joy to the world around you.
Thank you, Michelle. And now a performance from our senior chorus. So senior chorus members, please come back up.
Should have stayed on the farm, should have listened to my friends. You can't me die. Oh.
future lies beyond the yellow brick road. Ah, ah,
ah. Really beautiful. We will miss all of your voices. And while we're waiting for them to walk back to their seats, I would just like to express my gratitude tonight for this beautiful weather. We are so lucky that we were able to sneak this in amongst a week of bad weather, showers, cold weather, hot weather, you name it. It's happened in the last week or so, and it's going to continue to happen after today. So let's just give a round of applause for this lovely evening. I would like now to call up the salutatorian, Nina Wong, the class of 2023 salutatorian, as I said. All right.
Good evening, class of 2023, faculty, family, and friends. It is an honor to be addressing you today as salutatorian. First, I would like to extend my sincerest gratitude to my family for being my biggest supporters, to my friends for always staying by my side and being the best friends anyone could ask for, and to my teachers for guiding me throughout my high school career. 4 years ago, I could not have envisioned myself standing here delivering this speech on one of the most important days of my teenage life. I was nervous and unsure, with only a vague sense of my goals and aspirations. My future beyond high school was a formless, faraway daydream. I'm sure that many of you can relate. As a class, we've been through a lot together. We persevered through online schooling and quarantining during the pandemic, became a part of RHAM's new effort to increase diversity and equity awareness, witnessed joyous occasions of which there are too many to name. Through it all, we have remained strong, determined, and united. And finally, we've made it. Today, we celebrate the end of a journey and the start of a new one. In the story of our lives, this chapter has come to a close. We are turning the page and preparing to step into our own bright and unpredictable futures. As we say our goodbyes and leave this place behind, I ask you to remember this moment. Look at the faces around you, the friends and classmates who've walked this road with you for years, some since childhood, and etch this feeling into your memory. When I was writing this speech, I struggled for a long time. I agonized over the theme, the phrasing, the main ideas, searched for inspiring quotes, and scrapped half-finished drafts full of cliches, although I'm about to deliver some rather cliche lines anyway. What was there left to say? It didn't help that I only knew a fraction of this class. I was new to RHAM in freshman year and never truly branched out beyond the people who were always in my classes. However, when I think about my time at RHAM, it is those classmates who come to mind. The peers who saw that I was alone and offered to work together. The ones who walked with me to class when we were lost in the hallways, who eventually became my closest friends. These friendships have played a monumental role in making me who I am today. It is not an understatement to say that I would be a very different person if I had not met these people. Many of you probably feel the same way. At RHAM, I learned to value these relationships. It is the variety of perspectives, opinions, and backgrounds that shapes your character and helps you grow. And when you're tired and burnt out from endless studying and homework, you can join your friends at the Flower Girl after school, laugh with each other on a walk through the woods, or make pasta together from scratch on a snowy December night. These are the moments that I will remember for a very long time. And I encourage you to continue to make memories like these in the future. No matter what, the people around you will always be irreplaceable. Looking at all of you now, I know that after today, we will all walk on different paths. Although it is bittersweet, we all have our own stories to write, and I could not be more proud of that. I look forward to seeing what amazing things we'll accomplish someday, what great stories we'll have, and I hope that you'll remember where you came from, the experiences that and relationships that shape who you are and who you'll become. I wish you the greatest success in all your endeavors. I will leave you with these words from Oscar Wilde. Live. Live the wonderful life that is in you. Let nothing be lost upon you. Always be searching for new sensations. Be afraid of nothing. Congratulations, class of 2023. We've made it. Go on and make your mark in this world. Perhaps someday we will meet again. And wherever you may go, whoever you may become, however you choose to write your story, I hope that you'll be happy. Thank you and good luck.
Thank you, Nina. Now I'd like to welcome Dan Tamburo, our valedictorian for the class of 2023, back to the podium. Now you might think it's unusual that we have a class president who's the valedictorian, but in my 10 years here, this is like the second or third time that that has happened, so it's becoming a trend. Again, Dan?
This says 2022. My grandfather used to say that life is a dance between time and money. When you have more of one, you lack the other. For high schoolers, one might more accurately say that life is a dance between time and grades, or a social life into job or grades into sport. You get the idea. With so many commitments in our lives, I'm sure many of us have felt like we were being stretched thin over our high school years. With playoff games, essays, those late nights studying for chemistry, or even those late nights watching Netflix. What's worse is that plenty of us probably feel like we've just barely scraped by. But as we stand or sit here, as young adults poised to enter the world, I would ask you to remember how far we've come. In these classrooms, we have learned a wealth of knowledge far beyond what we could have ever hoped to understand on our own. Our eyes have been opened to a whole world of possibility. In these classrooms, we have had the honor to work with some of the most supporting and caring teachers we could have ever hoped to encounter. In these classrooms, we have been there for each other through our teenage years, through good times and bad. For many of us, we've been classmates for 6 years or more. At 18 years old, that's at least a third of our young lives. Trust me, I checked the math on that. In these classrooms, we have grown up. So while in the beginning of the year, I wrote about a quote concerning the value of hard work for Miss Mead's English class, reflecting now, I think it's important more than ever to emphasize that life is one wild, crazy adventure, if you'll excuse the cliche. It's a roaring, emotional, tear-jerking roller coaster with its ups, its downs, and everything in between. What makes it worth it is not some arbitrary measure of how hard you work. What makes it worth it is not fame or success. It's definitely not money, although that sure does make it easier. Any guesses? What makes it worth it is the people you meet along the way, the ones who love you, the ones who support you, believe in you, are there for you, the ones that you help, the ones you admire, friends, family, mentor, loved ones, you name it. These people give us purpose and kindness and love. These people are what make the human experience human. Keep them close and hold them tight. If the last part of my senior year has taught me anything, it's that every second we have together is truly a gift. I quote that great Swedish band ABBA. Sometimes I wish that I could freeze the picture and save it from the funny chicks of time. Grads, where would we be today if it weren't for the people who have influenced us on our journeys? Parents, family members, I'm sure you can all name someone that your life would not be the same without. I know I wouldn't be half the person I am today without my family. For the record, I never said that they make everything in life make sense. If someone figures that out, please let me know. But as we prepare to step out into the world, I only hope we can remember to enjoy the ride and to cherish the people. Hard work and dedication are important. Life is a dance between time and money. But I ask, no, I beg, that you remember those words from Marvel's Avengers. No amount of money ever bought a second of time. Thank you, and congratulations, class of 2023.
Thank you, Dan. At today's graduation rehearsal, I announce those who won awards and scholarships. Will those students please stand for recognition? I'd like to thank the community who contributed to those scholarships. Our students will definitely be better off going on their adventures, moving forward with the several scholarships that many of them won. So good job, guys. You may have a seat. The scholarships are also listed in the program. So the moment you've all been waiting for. I now would like to call up Ms. Lori Vega Belay to read the names, and the Chair of the Board of Education, Mr. Michael Morris, and the Superintendent, Mr. Colin McNamara, to present the diplomas.
Matthew Garneau. Megan Grace Luby. Julia Lynn Murachek. Logan Alexander Topolis. Aiden Thomas Zern. Matthew Dennis Tarallo. Christian Joseph Domenicone. Jack Patrick Luby. Mackenzie Lee Donnelly. Morgan Kate Sear. Nathaniel Mason Winman. Allie Catherine Bernier. Haley Ann Omen. Cadence Gabrielle Dietz. Shaylin Rose Dempsey. Christopher Lombardi. Summer Elise Akupchuk. Brady Anderson. Preston Dupre. Jake Pantalone. Matthew Robert Fago. Jace Dominique Spencer. Jessica Lynn Fagnoli. Nelia Lee Bergeron. Alexa Hutchings D'Onofrio. Anastasia Gavrish. Bethany Dosher. Bryn Delaney Mallorin. Olivia Grace Weingarten. Daniel Frank Tamboro. Ryan Woods. Cameron Talcott Rhodes. Luke Edward Pollowitzer. Jacob Augusto Balula. Paige Elizabeth O'Brien. Sophia Loren Orama. Jenna Lee Humphreys. Samara Catherine Zygmunt. Ryan Frederick Gauthier. Chase Michael Massey. Holden Sullivan. Logan Quinn Hester. Michael Lewis Hamburger. Ella Bryn Hall. Sophie Walsh. Margarita Maria Tomanovich. Charlotte Frost Atwood. Emily Nicole Bakke. Kristen Elizabeth Sislowski. William Giacone. Griffin Thompson. Carson Waddell. Max Nyland. Anna Elizabeth Lavenberg. Kira Morgandy Murray. Hadley Ann Marchand. Emma Jean Rhodes. Vincent Terlecki. Sydney Vaccaro. Abigail Amber Pace. Nina Wong. Benjamin Paul Cancellaro. Sophia Suzanne Peeling. Autumn Sky Worthen. Stephanie Yvonne Delaney. Nina Kaylin Holm. Yeah. Bridget Grabsky. Ava Dean. Grace Newmyth. Chelsea Maria Egazarian. Sonia Remish. Kaylin Calhoun. Rachel Catherine Bartolucci. Ariana Roslyn Patriolo. Maria Felicitas Villanueva. Madigan Sky Haddock. Madeline Elizabeth Murray. Riley Ann Panico. Allie Hadley. Maxwell Stanley Zarnicki. David Panetta. Cecilia Ann Chu. Jenna Mae Stankiewicz. Maxwell J. Cementa. Cole James Pilkington. Ryan Carlton Hennigan. Kincaid Knox Sylvia. Ethan Rosa. Jessica Day. Natalia Wapaya Rojas. Alisa Hines. Emma Julia McGuire. Isabel Marie Mondo. Winter Torres. Abby Billings. Danelli De La Cruz. Caitlin Aldridge. Ethan Demosthenes. Cooper Halitek. Simon E. Kunenkiel. Matthew R. Frawley. Garrett Kelleher. Dylan Alexander Kohler.
You got that's two.
Justin Crom. Connor Townsend. Peyton Allen Cody. Davion Hernandez. Gage Stacy. Anthony Viveros. Roan Traskis. Lainey Marie Cameron. Lila May Patriz. Elena Marie Caruso Comtois. Danny Shanny. Riley Harrington. Mia Angelina Francesca Tyler. Samantha Spinelli.
Oh my gosh.
You didn't want to graduate? Emily Tavallari. Lauren Ruth Feige. Dylan Gasparini. Dylan. Caden Hutchins. Conrad Janjinski. Cameron William McDonald. Michael Marquise. Allie Elaine Deckman. Diana Marie Zito. Sarah West. Grace Lee Barron. Grace Kelly Whitmore. Michael Angel Rivera. Samara Raza. Jonah Regan Chudzik. Dustin Hussein. Destiny Cecile Simkowski. Alyssa Chisholm. Ethan Lassard. Sebastian Bucino. Olivia Swearingen. Cole Clossy. Christopher Lawson Devine. Matthew Granatini. Jeremy Dylan Devine. Ethan Claude Polochanan. Quinn Christian Arnold. Mark Joseph Chu. Eric Andrew Budin. Matthew Edward Bogdan. Kodak Rodriguez. Benjamin Eric Clay. Elijah Zikafoos. Anthony Andrew Wursthorn. Julian Emerson Scott. Jack Henry Campbell. Aiden Gregory Rosati. Alec Elton Byrne. Samuel Forrest. Michaela Marie Chicoin. Caden Smith. Tiffany Marie Warren. Linnea Carlson. Robin Rodriguez. Bridget Austin. Chloe Lorelei Weathers. Hunter James Slayton. Shannon Lee Lowell. Elise Marie Catania. Laura Grace Filosa. Amy Lorraine Aston. Selena Del Valle. Sam Senis. Patrick Alexander Dunko. Zachary P. Syme. Nathaniel Michael Aguiar. Bella Ray Rose. Phoebe Rose Allen. Kyle Eckert.
Rowan Stephen Ackerland. Jared Langevin. Ian Thomas Costello. David Malajnowski. Xavier Ingenito. Julius Totten. Caden Duesenberg. Zach Engel. Tommy Putzer. Drake Everlith. Ben E. Delton. Harrison Moorcroft. Jacob Magnus Skoog. Josh Gauthier. Brady Easton Lalonde. Hayden Stanley Gilnack. Bradley Andrew Lim. Ariana Mia Isabel St. Ange. Jonathan Joseph Goldstein. Will Coates. Miguel Angel Janang. Caleb Fitzsimmons. Evan Kreidler. And certainly not least, Evan Davis.
Ladies and gentlemen, it is my distinct pleasure to present to you the class of 2023. As Our recent graduates, you may now take your tassels and move them from the right to the left. Congratulations, everyone.
Now I call Jake Pantalone and Allie Deckman up for the last roller coaster for 2023. Thank you for joining us today. Have a wonderful and safe evening. Seniors, please come inside for your diplomas.